गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल डियर स्टूडेंट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 24 ऑफ एचईपी ह्यूमन एनाटॉमी एंड फिजियोलॉजी टाइटल टू स्टडी द स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शन ऑफ फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम। माय सेल्फ मिस्टर सचिन सुरेश कोरडे फ्रॉम केके वाघ इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मेसी चांदोरी। नाउ द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट इज टू अंडरस्टैंड द लोकेशन स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ऑर्गन्स ऑफ फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम, टू अंडरस्टैंड द साइट ऑफ ओम फॉर्मेशन, टू अंडरस्टैंड द रोल ऑफ ईच ऑर्गन्स in functioning overall this system. These are the learning objective in this experiment. These are the component of our female reproductive system. Here is the vagina, here is the ovary, this is uterus, fallopian tube, and the structure is called as cervix. The structure is called as cervix, and this is the uterus and this vagina. And this is the labium minus. These are the typical structures of our female reproductive systems. Now we will see the each organs one by one. Female reproductive system produce the sex hormones like estrogen and progesterone. It also produce the egg, ova, and also support and protect the developing embryo, give the birth to new baby. These are the functions of our female reproductive system. Major organs: cervix is the major organ, vagina is the major organ, ovaries is the major organs, uterine tube, fallopian tubules, fallopian tube is the major organs, and uterus, here is the uterus. These are the major component of our female reproductive systems. Now see the cervix, the lower portions of neck of the uterus. This portion is called as cervix. This portion is called as cervix. Here it is shown. The cervix is lined with the mucus known as the cervical mucus. Cervical mucus provides the lubrication and sperm transport during the sexual intercourse. From this, sperm will be transported. During the ovulation, secretions of cervical mucus increase in response to estrogen. But when an egg is ready for fertilization, the mucus then becomes thin and sleepy, offering a friendly environment to a sperm. The cervix at the end of pregnancy. The cervix acts as the passage through the baby exits the uterus into the vagina. It will be passage from the cervix into the vagina. The cervical canal expands to roughly 50 times its normal width. The passage of the baby during the birth, it will be the contact, it will be the expands 50 times more as compared to the normal. And next is the vagina. The muscular ridged sheath connecting the external genitals to the uterus. These are the external genitals of our female, that is called as vagina. Functions as a two-way street accepting the penis and sperm during the intercourse, serving as the avenue of birth through which the new baby enters the world. Ovaries, also known as the female gonads. They produce eggs, also called ova. Every female is born with a lifetime supply of eggs. They also produce the hormones estrogen and progesterone. This is the place of ovaries. It will be located at the end of fallopian tube. This is the structure. Here is the cervix. This is the vagina, uterus, fallopian tube. These are the egg. Fallopian tubes stretch from the uterus to the ovaries and measures about 8 to 13 cm in length. The ends of fallopian tube lying next to the ovaries feather into the ends called the fimbria. Millions of the tiny hairs like cilia line the fimbria and the interior of the fallopian tube. The cilia beat in waves 100 times a second, catching the egg at ovulation and moving it through the tube to the uterine cavity. Fertilization typically occurs in the fallopian tube. Generally, fertilization occurs in this point. Sperm comes and it will be made to the egg, and that egg is fertilized and it will be comes into this place. Release of egg from the ovary, the egg reaches to the midpoint of fallopian tube where it fertilized by sperm. Implantation of fertilized egg into the endometrium of uterus. Uterus is the pear-shaped muscular organs in the female reproductive tract. The fundus is the upper portion of the uterus where the pregnancy occurs. The cervix is the lower portion of the uterus that connects with the vagina and serves as a sphincter to keep the uterus closed during the pregnancy until it is the time to deliver a baby. The uterus expands considerably during the reproductive process. The organs grows to form 10 to 20 times its normal size during the pregnancy. Uterus, this is the typical structures of our uterus. The main body consists of a firm outer coat of muscles. Myometrium and in inner lining of vascular ganglion matria, endometrium. The endometrium thickens during the menstruation cycle to allow the implantation of a fertilized egg. Pregnancy occurs when the fertilized egg implants successfully into the endometrium lining. Endometrium is the normal endometrium. The endometrium is the innermost layer of the uterus. During the menstruation cycle, the endometrium grows to a thick blood vessels rich glandular tissue layer that represent an optimal environment for the implantation of a blastocyst upon its arrival in the uterus. Endometrium is a central echogenic and has an average thickness of 6.7. During the pregnancy, the blood vessels in the endometrium further increase in the size and number and forming the placenta. Placenta supplies the oxygen nutrition to the embryo and fetus. Thank you so much. From this experiment, we understand the major component of our reproductive systems and their location as well as their structures and as well as their function of female reproductive system. Thank you so much.